Hey guys, what's up? I'm Jack. Hey guys, what's up? I'm EonThief. Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD. In the last video, we did some stuff. We killed a thing. It was awesome. And we're kind of trapped in here, but we got this cool spiky chest. And inside is the greatest item. No, the greatest item's still the hookshot. I stand by that. Not the hookshot, the grappling. We get the boomerang, though. It's actually kind of weird we get the boomerang this early on. So the boomerang in this game is a little different than it is in other games. In fact, actually in this game, the boomerang acts in a way that it targets. This was the first game to introduce the boomerang doing any kind of targeting at all. I believe it was. Was it? Pretty sure. Yeah, because before this, it was just like, you better hope you can hit. Now, however, we can both deal with P-hats, because we can kill them, we can smack them, and we can just cut their stems. I think we can actually, like, yeah, we can kill them too with the boomerang if we so choose. Aha! I love that. So, with the boomerang, though, we can also progress further in the dungeon. Now, I was wondering how I wanted to go about handling a certain aspect of this game. Doing something I never actually seen many other Let's Players really do. Again, when it comes to this game. Did that really just happen? Okay, cool. Well, I guess I'll just go back through this the freaking long way. Wow. I guess thank God for that Boko Bobber, right? Okay, you know what, bud? I'm just gonna smack you. So in this, the boomerang does do what it did before, where it will stun things. And now we can progress further through the dungeon if I don't mess up again. I do want to get this thing off me because I don't know if it's going to be a detriment, but in the event that it is, you know, it can't hurt. Where was the... Was it this one? Was this the mini... No, this is the room. So... I would like to make it through this room peacefully. Please, for the love of everything in this world that's holy. Also, I like that the boomerang will curve back towards you, avoiding, it avoids, for the most part, what was I gonna say? Like, it, for the most part, does a good job of avoiding things that it could hit in its path. There are certain times, though, when it will just be like, nah, fam, I'm just gonna clip through everything. Because why not? Why not, right? Also, now that we have the boomerang, we can do... Can I... Get all five of them. I also like that the boomerang will... what's the word I'm looking for? The boomerang will actually... like, lock on and attack the things in the order you want to attack them in. So that's kind of nice. So if you lock on to something, and then go completely in the other direction, the boomerang will do that just to kind of show that, which I like. I think that's a really cool feature. So the boomerang does a few things, though. Okay, I'm going to just do this and kill both of them. Double kill, because I'm pro AF, boys. However, I went this way because I believe this is... I know this is an optional chest. I'm fairly positive this isn't a key. But, oh, it's a joy pendant. I don't need those. I don't think I need those. Just real quick, let me check the map to make sure I'm not going the wrong way. Oh, is this actually the way to the boss? Really? The boss... Yeah, the boss door's right here. Huh. Well, Know what I'm going to do. Oh, by the way, another way you can get these things off is by just using fire. Fireworks for everything. I'm going to keep that open, though, because you never know when you're going to have to go back through that door. And we will, because obviously that's the way to the boss. But more importantly, I'm going to go ahead and show off the cool thing I was debating on whether or not I wanted to show off or not. Okay, Link. Okay, so I actually think the, I can't actually use words right now. Fall in the water. Oh, you can actually lock onto these things as boomerang too, and it will kill them, but they're, you know, not annoying enough that it really matters. Also, please die, P-Hat. Die, foul monster, you don't belong in this world. Did you like that little quote? It's Castlevania. Because I'm clever. Also, those hands, I don't know what those hands really do, if they really do anything worthwhile, but yeah. You can... They do something, I guess. They slow you down. Also, another rupee I don't need, but of course, I feel the need to get every chest. Oh, also, if you don't cut these in time, they will all return, so the only thing that would make sense to do is not fall. How do I get back up? Okay, I was actually really worried because I've never fallen down there. So I was a little worried. But also, as you can see, we're just a little too far to be able to get all of those. So we have to cut it down like this. And now that we've cut it down... What's in here? I forget. Oh, another door. Oh, this room. Okay, so, for this room, this is one of the more interesting ones. Also, I did not know that the Bokobaba plant will actually just get one shot by the boomerang. So that's kind of cool to know. And let's go and just try and kill as many of these as we can. Yeah, good enough. And I do like that the game is nice enough to not just absolutely screw you. Like, it could. If the game really wanted to be mean, it could screw you over right there. You could just get, you know, locked out of that because the game decided like, I think I want to go ahead and, you know, how dare you? That's why you're going to get destroyed by my boomerang. I just like that, though. I think that's really, really cool that it's that works that way. However, this room is a very interesting room because, as you saw, there's that in there. Now, we can't actually lock onto it with our boomerang from where we are, so what we have to do is this. Yep, that's all we had to do. I actually was a little worried that, like, oh, maybe I can't actually throw the bomb from there, and, like, I have to drop it and pick it back up and throw it, but no, you can just throw it from where you were. And this is our another treasure chart. This is actually, I think, the last treasure chart we're going to be getting in this little area of the game, which I think's really, or this area, I want to say. If I miss any treasure charts, I will do, like, a little pickup episode where I just go and pick up a bunch of the treasure charts I may have missed. And I, oh god, you suck. That's right, get back down here, you dick. And of course the Octrock is also back because, well, it couldn't stay away, I guess. Now, we are on a flower, we are on water, and technically we can do something about that. I don't know why we're going as slow as we are. I don't know if there's any way to speed this up. Give me that heart. Full hearts. I don't think there's any real way to speed it up. I think we just have to do this and pray the game decides when it wants to let's go fast. How dare you? Again, I like that you don't really have to aim where you're sending the things. Okay, so this should... Come on. Yeah, we don't need to do anything. Yeah, I think those grabby things just prevent us from moving. Not that it really matters. That being said, welcome to this little area of the thing. So you already kind of know what we have to do. You saw a few of them. And the boomerang locks on to 5 targets. There are just so happens to be 5 targets in this room. And if you fall down here, you just do a little, you know, gets you down to where the chest is just a bit faster. However, I said I'm going to show off something a little cooler with the boss that I don't see people do very often. Oh, also these guys. So these guys have a thing. If I just steal it from them, that just... Oh, you. How dare you? Oh god, I hate moblins. I hate them. Yeah, moblins can hit very fast. They're one of the few enemies in this game that actually give me some trouble. However, just using the boomerang will stun them. And I'm probably gonna end up using my fairy here. I'm totally gonna end up using my fairy here, but it's okay because I need the empty bottle space anyway. Are you dead? Die! See, if you're too close to a moblin, it will absolutely just poo on you. But it should be dead. I think I got both the skull pendants. Not that it really meant... I think I actually could have save-quitted out of that fight anyway, but guess what? That's what we're gonna do. We gonna save-quit. And I'm actually gonna see you guys back at the Forest Haven, though. Inside the Forest Haven, so... Yeah, I'll see you guys in just a minute. So if we come into the Forest Haven, and we're gonna have to be a little fast about this, but we have to go into the deeper water, like water right, I think here is fine. So in here, we get forest water. You can use this water multiple times, but it loses its freshness in 30 minutes. So now we are on a timer, but that's okay. And the timer also kind of shows how long it's... I think the timer only goes down once you're, like, not in the Forest Haven. So long as you stay in the Forest Haven, the water timer doesn't seem to be going down unless it's just a glitch, or... I don't really know. Is it a glitch, or is it just, like, the game being kind to me? Oh, nope. Wanted to not do that. Not do that. That's not what I meant to do at all. But yeah. So we're actually going to need that. And I'm going to put... I guess I'll put that back over the grappling hook for now. Or over the boomerang for now. Because we don't really need the boomerang. Or we're not going to need the boomerang for a bit. In fact, I really just need to get to high enough so that... I feel a bit better. Come on, make it back. Yeah. So once we get to a certain point, we're going to do a little something and we're gonna do a little bit of cheese. Then again, I don't see any YouTubers do for this. I don't know why they don't. I don't know if they think it's just that's too easy or what, but I think it's fine to do. In fact, I've, again, never seen it done, so I'd like to see it in the Let's Play. So, let's go ahead and get our magic back, because as you know, well, we're going to have to make it back into the Forest Haven. Yeah, so as long as you're actually in the Forest Haven, you're good to go, but, yeah, so I think we actually can't make it over there. Also, the timer goes down even when you're in a pause menu, I believe, so you better get real good at moving in this game. and fast, because the timer does, I don't think it actually did go down all too much. So I'm going to have to hurry, because I'm also going to need to get magic here, because I need to, A, change the... You know what? I'll see you guys back at the Forest Haven. I'll see you guys back in, like, the Forbidden Woods. Okay, here we are, back in the Forest Haven, in the boss room, nonetheless. Because we used a cool little warpity warp pipe, and we were able to get in there just fine. So, fun fact about this boss actually has two different ways you can beat it. You can, of course, just wail on it with a sword, which, that's boring. Who would want to do that? I believe this enemy is called the Biobaba? Don't quote me on that. I might be wrong. I'll put the actual name of the enemy on screen right now. And to beat this boss, we have to, well, obviously use our boomerang. You see the things that are pulling it up off the ground. Well, we need to boomerang those. Also, we need to avoid its weird stick thingies, its weird claw things. Okay, also... So if you just, like, manage to strafe around this thing and use your boomerang as you strafe and just kind of lock on like that, you're basically good to go. These, like, the things it has won't hit all too hard. In fact, I don't think they hit very hard at all. And once you do that, it does its thing. But guess what? You pour some forest water on it and it dies. Yeah, that's it. That's the boss. It's so easy. It's so easy. And I don't see any Let's Players do that, like, do that quick kill. I don't. And I can see why. It cheeses it. But guess what? Fun fact, spoiler alert, we're going to be fighting this boss again by the end of the game anyway. Swordsman, are you the one who rescued me? You have my thanks. When all went dark around me, I thought my time on the earth was over. But why are you here, swordsman? What? The great Deku Tree sent you? Oh, that's right. Today's the day of our annual ceremony. Oh, I'm in trouble. I shouldn't be here. I should get out of here immediately. But yeah, like, we fight this boss later, so it's not like there isn't a chance to actually show the fight off proper. So... why wait? Why not do it right the first time? It's weird to me. Why not do the quick kill to show it off? Because you cannot do the quick kill in that boss fight, I believe. I think it limits you to the items that you could have had on hand. The forest water is not one of them, because the forest water is a special item. I don't actually need the forest water, though, so I'm going to go ahead and put my grappling hook back over it. I don't, again, really need it. So, yeah. But this warp will again take us out of the dungeon and to where we need to go. Also, Makar is going to follow us too, because he's pretty alright. Makar's alright. I like Makar. He's a good kid. Good kid. Also, in case you couldn't tell, the Koroks were born of the Deku, or they're evolved from the Kokiri. You know, Korok, Kokiri. Makes sense. Oh, Makar, you've returned safely.
I'm sorry, Great Deku Tree. I know you warned us many times, but I still did not listen.
Do not worry, Makar. You are safe now. Just be more careful from now on. You've done well, Link. I must thank you for your brave deeds. Here's that which I promised you. Please accept it. And you'll never guess where it was.
Shaking around in his tree branches. I think it would have been better if he would have, like, just snotted it out at you through his nose. I think that would have been much, much better, but, I guess that'll do.
But we receive Pharaoh's Pearl, the Earth Spirit, the Deku Tree, has seen fit to give you this jewel, a treasure of the goddess Pharaoh. It is my hope that this pearl shall lead you to a fair destiny. All is well, Makar. Do not cry. Please, play your songs for me, as you always do.
Oh, that's right. We must begin our ceremony soon, before the day ends. I'm sorry to keep you all waiting. Let the ceremony begin. Oh, great, Link. As my thanks to you, I shall play even harder than I normally do.
Like, are you going heavy? Are you going to drop it? Are you going to, like, gent?
palm mute aggressively, like, bud, you got this. Show me the way, Makar.
I hope you enjoy it.
Now, under normal circumstances, I'd probably just do, like, a joke here and put some, like, music over this, like, some djent, some, like, generic djent over this because I made the joke already, but, like, you know what? So it's, like, I like the song. It's a good song. But now, this actually sparks a long, long quest that we're not going to be doing much of for a bit. In fact, it's actually going to be a very, very long time before we do it. Probably like close to the end of the game when I'm going to wrap things up. But we'll see. We'll see more about that later.
Great Deku Tree, this year you have once again produced some splendid seeds. With these seeds, we will continue to spread the forest across the great sea. Let us go, Koroks. To the sea! See you all next year. Take care.
Farewell, great swordsman. May the winds of chance bring us together again someday.
Oh, they will. Oh, they will. Because the item, the forest water, there's a reason it has a timer on it. And it's not just to make killing getting the quick kill on the boss that much harder. No, it has a timer on it because, well, it's a timed quest. Yeah, the quest is timed. Oh, it's so annoying to me that that's the case. Like, I hate it so much more than I should. It's like, I shouldn't hate it. It's kind of cool, you know? Like, nice timed quests. Like, you don't see those very often. And I lie, every Zelda game has them. Like, every 3D Zelda game has them, I'll say. But now that we've done that, ooh, we got some mail!
Good evening! Letters for Link, we have one letter. Here is your letter.
The postbox talk, and they have deep voices.
Dear Link, if you're reading this letter, it can only mean that you've peeked into one of our many postbox. I'm indebted to you. I'm very sorry I leave you without thanking you. Please accept my heartfelt apology, along with my thanks. We cannot do much to help you, but we can at least do this. If you get any if we get any letters or parcels for you, we will deliver them to a post box near you. If you see any wiggling post box, please look inside them. I suppose you have a long way to go before your perilous journey is done. I've included a gift for you with my letter in hopes that it might help you. Please accept a small token. I look forward to the day when we meet again. May fortune fill your wings. From Kamali's father.
And with this, we get our second heart piece. I thought we got one. I thought we got one before. Yeah, this is our second heart piece. We're going to be getting a lot more of those later. As of right now, we're not super concerned with heart pieces. But now that we've done this, so this place too has been attacked by Ganon. Could he already be regaining his power? Link, you must get to the remaining pearl. It lies in a place northwest of here. We must set sail immediately. And in fact, yes, the final pearl is, if I check the thing and go to our map, it is over here. This is an island we have yet to go to. In fact, it is an island that we will go to at a much, much later date. With that being said, I say much later, but we're going there right now, basically, man. Like, we're ready to go. In fact, I just want to make sure before we do set sail, and before I end the video, that the wind is set to the proper direction, and it is not. Now it is. You said northwest, right? Yeah, northwest. Wait a second. Is this the right way to go? This is the right way to go. Either way, that's going to end it for today's video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, a like rating is always appreciated. And, you know, you could subscribe too. That would also be really awesome. That being said, I'm EonThief, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Till then.